And this is what I had to become aware of on my pilgrimage to Mecca. I'm speaking now from what I think, from what I have seen, from what I have analyzed, and the conclusions that I have reached. If I judge a man by his conscious behavior, I am not a racist. I don't subscribe to any of the tenets of racism.
Then there are good whites and good blacks and bad whites and blacks.
It's not a case of being good and bad, good or bad blacks and whites. It's a case of being good or bad human being.
When I was on the pilgrimage, I had close contact with Muslims whose skin would in America be classified as white, and with Muslims who themselves would be classified as white in America. But these particular Muslims didn't call themselves white. They looked upon themselves as human beings, as part of the human family, and therefore they looked upon all other segments of the human family as part of that same family. Well, now, they had a different look or a different air or a different attitude than that which is reflected in the attitude of the man in America who calls himself white. So I said that if Islam had done that for them, perhaps if the white man in America would study Islam, perhaps it could do the same thing for him.
Malcolm, just to...
Stop researching this. Yeah. If you don't become Shia, you're going to come close to it, because you'll know, look, there's something happening here. Mm. Something's been kept from you.
When going through some of the most notable Shia hadith works, it's not uncommon to encounter some racist content in these books. What the Shia essentially have done is, they've attributed racist content to their imams, effectively giving it a religious and moral basis. Now, take this as an example. This is a chapter in Kitab al-Kafi by al-Kulayni called Babu man kuriha munakahatuhu min al-akradi wa sudani wa ghayrihim. Those from whom marriage is discouraged, such as the Kurds, the blacks, and others.
Oh man, jeez.
The first report he quotes in this chapter is a quote to Abi Abdullah, an Abi Abdullah alayhi salam, qala amir al-mu'minin alayhi salam, iyyakum wa nikahu al-zinj fa innahu khalqun mushawwah. So they supposedly quote Ja'far al-Sadiq, rahimahullah, supposedly quoting Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu, saying, "Beware from marrying from the blacks, for they are a distorted creation."
You have lost your minds.
If we were to analyze the isnad of this report, according to the Shia standards, we'd recognize that it's authentic. And that is what Al-Majlisi declares in his book, Mir'at al-Uqul, where he mentions that the hadith is sahih. Now, it's quite ironic to see blacks in general adopt this religion, not knowing what it entails. Because apparently, to the Shia version of Ali ibn Abi Talib, a black Muslim is too physically defective for a pure Arab or a pure Persian to marry.
When other people are calling you those names and you're standing by idly, there's something wrong up here.
So now this is another report, also in Kitab al-Kafi by al-Kulayni, where Kulayni says, وعنه عن أحمد بن أبي عبد الله وغيره أنه كتب إليه يسأله عن الأكراد فكتب إليه لا تنبهوهم إلا بحد السيف. So Ahmad ibn Abi Abdullah and others write a letter to the Imam Abu Muhammad asking him about the Kurds. What does the Imam respond? The Imam responds saying, "Do not make them aware of your presence except by the blade of your swords." Now, if we were to analyze the isnad of this hadith, we'd recognize that it's authentic according to the Shia standards. And that's what Al-Majlisi says in Mir'at al-Uqul, where he declares the report to be sahih.
How is it that deep that you lot are completely unconscious of what's going on?
This is another example in Kitab al-Kafi by al-Kulayni, where al-Kulayni says, عن أبي عبد الله عليه السلام قال إني جربت جواري بيضاء وأدماء فكان بينهن بون. So he quotes Ja'far al-Sadiq saying, "I've tried white women and darker women, and I've noted a huge difference between them." Now, looking at the isnad of this hadith, we see that it's authentic, and that's what Al-Majlisi says in Mir'at al-Uqul. Now, if we were to look at the understanding of the Shia jurists of this hadith, we'd see where the racism lies. So, the Shia jurist and muhaddith, Al-Hurr al-Amiri, lists this report under the chapter, Bab istihbabi tazweej al-bayda'i wal-zarqa'. So, the chapter is called The Preference of Marrying a Lighter-Skinned Woman. And Al-Burujurdi, in his book Jami' Ahadith al-Shia, also includes this report under the chapter Bab al-Targhib fi tazweej al-bayda'i wal-zarqa', The Enticement of marrying a lighter-skinned woman.
Jeez!
As a parent, the blacks, the Kurds, are not the most fortunate people under Shia Islam. But we could expand that list. If we were to consider a bunch of other weaker reports, which Shia jurists still consider reliable in their fiqh books, we'd come off with a much larger list. So you have examples where the imams condemn the Khazarians, the Indians, the Sindhis, the Kandaharis. You also have the imams claiming that the Kurds are originally jinn and whatnot. So the bottom line is, if you really want to join the KKK, why go through the hassle? Just become a Shia.